Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Athletics and Recreation Center on the campus of Queen's University in Kingston, Ontario for the 2017 Canadian Futsal Championship game day number two. And we're getting Futsal Club Toronto taking on the Saskatchewan champions Olimipia SK FC. I am Kyle Compo, joined alongside by Chris Fernandez. And Chris, FCT wearing their blues today, hoping to bring them better fate from that game yesterday against the Quebec champs, the Sporting Outlaws.
Yeah, certainly wasn't their best performance yesterday out there, but they were able to gain a little bit of momentum with a couple of goals in that second half. But unfortunately for them, falling 9-3 to Sporting Outlaws.
Ball comes to the outside, trying to get our first attack on goal, and there's a name that we're quite familiar with, number 6, Fitzroy Christie, Chris, and making his way out to Saskatchewan, going to be someone to watch out for in this game today.
He's one of my favorite players in the history of Canadian futsal. Fitz played over him for the Canadian team back in 2008 when they went down to Brazil for the Grand Prix, and he's absolutely a phenomenal player.
And a great check ball inside right to start out of the corner and burying it home right away, number 9, Jay Tomchuk. What a start for Saskatchewan.
Hey, you know what? This team has only been put together for this year. The Saskatchewan Soccer Association has done a phenomenal job. I mean, baked from scratch out there. You had all those people initially with Doug Peterson and Dave Nutt and Hammy Meza, the coach from Columbia out here for Olimipia SKFC, doing a phenomenal job building it out there in the prairies. And to see them come out and get the early goal right here in their first inaugural Futsal Canadian Championship is an absolute dream, and excellent job by everybody involved, not just the players.
A lot of the same faces we saw yesterday for FCT, including Matias DeMarco, who takes the free kick, but a little bit too long in delivering it, so that'll be a turnover, and it'll be Olimipia setting up on the far side as the officials try to get some stuff reset on that back end. But again, we saw FCT yesterday fall behind early and often to the Sporting Outlaws and having forced to play catch-up the rest of the game with that extra attacker, namely Matias DeMarco, filling that role. And we'll see if they can get back into this one a little bit quicker so that they aren't forced into that same situation as they were yesterday. Attack comes in from the outside, but it's wasted as it's sent long. And taking responsibility for that is Gerson Berendica, number 10 for Olimipia. Jorge comes to the outside to Ortel, trying to get the check ball inside, as posting in up top was Mauricio DeMarco. Make that Kovacevic. Jorge sends the ball off the edge there of Tomchuk, and then it'll go to bounds. It'll be a corner kick. DeMarco will take the corner. Kovacevic in up top. Get the ball inside, and last deflected out by Olimipia.
Yeah, I think with Olimipia, we're going to be seeing a very, very tight 2-2 box system out there. Coach.
Tomchuk comes back in the counter, tries to lay it off. And it comes back to Tomchuk just wide of the net. And there's that great touch from Fitzroy Christie as he gets the check ball to come right back inside, just outside the arc, just wide of the net.
Well, we were talking about them putting a more defensive structure out there. But, boy, on the offense immediately, they're coming in with two attempts, one of which they've already been rewarded for. And they're looking pretty strong early on here in the first.
See Christie marking up top on Kovacevic, trying to not allow that big frame inside to post up. And it's deflected out of bounds by Olimipia, so it'll be a side ball touch-in upcoming from FCT. We saw David Campesano in the warm-up, the goaltender for FCT, looking sharp, but that first ball coming in from Tomchuk, able to squeak through just underneath the leg there of Campesano. And we'll see if Olimipia can add to their lead here in the early part of the first half. Ball comes back to Dianchenko, goes to the outside, trying to come square to Fitzroy, and it's off, and it's in! Kovacevic gets the goal to tie it for FCT, and a defensive miscue at the back end from Dianchenko.
Yeah, that's something they're going to want really early on out there, is to make sure they get the momentum. They're used to that back home in Toronto, and sitting there with a great player such as Mario Kovacevic doing his job, making sure that they're getting back on the board and really, really going to get some good momentum here for FCT early on here in the first half.
Tomchuk trying to respond for Olimipia. Comes to the back end, a good movement across the court. Dianchenko waiting for it at the back, but instead holding on will be Berenik Vasily. Vasily to the inside to Tomchuk. Back to Vasily, great stretch ball through, trying to get it loose, and it's Kovacevic going to poke the ball out, and it's going to be a corner upcoming for Olimipia.
We're going to see the ball here most likely go to Fitzroy Christie, former national team player.
Christie gets it at the back, comes across to Tomchuk. Trying to break through this box here, Tomchuk. Fakes the shot, it comes back to Christie. Christie makes the move to the inside, but it's intercepted. Now Vasily trying to hang on. Vasily makes a move inside. He's fouled hard by Eduardo Jorge. So that'll be Olimpia possession in the offensive half.
Yeah, we talked about the impact that Eduardo Jorge has, not just with his club, but also with the national team out there. A very aggressive player, tons of heart, sometimes a little hard to control with the temper. He, you know, has a little tendency to put the hot water on, but definitely one of the top leaders on this club and one of the best players out here in the country. So make sure you watch for the number three in blue today.
DeMarco makes it come through. Here's Jorge. Goes off the leg there of Tomchuk. Goes to the outside. Jorge going to inbound on that far side. Make that DeMarco who's going to come in and play the ball. He's got some options at the back. Goes to Kovacevic, the goal scorer for FCT. Christie lays it off at the back, trying to come across to Tomchuk, intercepted by Jorge. DeMarco unable, and it's kept in nicely at the side, but intercepting on that far side defensively there from Olimpia, but it's cleared out by Tomchuk on the side. As trying to get it loose, there was Baranek Vasily, and he goes hard down to the floor, but no foul called.
Yeah, I can tell you right now, I see the size of some of these boys from Saskatchewan, those big prairie boys. I wouldn't want to run into them anytime soon, that's for sure.
Corner kick up coming up for FCT. Kovacevic looking for it inside. It was left all alone, but unable to get it through. Now it's Christie coming back the other way. Lays the ball off, and it's intercepted by DeMarco, but goes right back to Christie. Christie, poked to the inside. Gets it right back. Left foot convert. Looking for the corner kick, but it's going to be Campusano possession. Jorge to DeMarco. Gains the center court line, and we'll drop it off, and we'll get our first substitution from FCT. Is coming on will be Brandon Samoas. Going to go off the leg and out of play off the last touched out by DeMarco. So Fitzroy Christie going to inbound. He's got Dianchenko behind him. But Christie looking up court, trying to play that ball in. The referee will blow the whistle. It'll be a turnover on the side. Taking a little bit too long once again to inbound for Olimpia.
Yeah, it's hard to imagine Fitzroy Christie, 35 years of age and moving like he's 21 years old. Native of Kitchener, Ontario. Played for years over in the Toronto leagues before moving out to Saskatchewan, making a new life out there and building futsal in the process.
Jorge goes to the far side. Gets it into Samoas. Kovacevic. Excuse me, trying to get Samoas there at that time as DeMarco has the ball come across. Jerson Berendica going to inbound and play that ball in. Again, Dianchenko calling for it, but they're going to go to Christie. Fitzroy Christie gets it caught up there in the feet of Kovacevic. They still come across. Berendica, great chip ball forward. Tomchuk thought about going up for it, but unable to make an effort on the ball. So Campusano will play it in tight. We'll see Francesco Capone come onto the floor now for FCT. DeMarco looking for it back in the 1-2, and he will get it, but last off his foot. So Tomchuk will play the ball in, or he will leave it instead for Fitzroy Christie. And now an off the ball foul is writhing in pain in the offensive half. And they're going to call for the trainer to come on for number 8. Salatsidis. And now getting into it on that far side with Matias DeMarco.
Yeah, the 27-year-old native of Saskatoon not happy about that, taking a hard knock, and then these floors are unforgiving, to say the least, out there. There's no cushion of the grass to protect him out there, and Salatsidis wasn't happy, to say the least.
Paul comes to the top to Salatsidis, tries to get it through DeMarco, and now DeMarco and Christie in a battle. DeMarco wins that one. Lays it off, trying to get it through to Capone, but Olimpia will settle down. Come to the near side. Great run out of the back end. Trying to get it through that time was Berendica, but unable to squeeze it through. Had nobody in front of him. DeMarco trying to come back in the counter. Jorge goes to the far side, and almost getting it intercepted at the back end was Salatsidis. But DeMarco will collect. He's got Berendica bearing down on him, and now they're trying to get the stretch ball up top. Here's Samoas. Can't get it through. Big save, and squeezes through. And Salatsidis brings it back into the crease, and not taking any chances. Alex Dianchenko just going to clear that ball out of harm's reach.
Definite confident keeper out there. Ukrainian background, Alexander Dianchenko. really trying to make his presence felt early on here.
So 1-1 still in the early part of the first half. A much better start here for Futsal Club Toronto. We mentioned yesterday a tough start for them in the opening half against the Sporting Outlaws, the champions from Quebec, which ultimately led to a 9-3 loss. So this is an absolute must-win for them, Chris, and they almost get the equal push through for that go-ahead goal. And Frankie Capone unable to believe that one as the head ball goes off the post and then collected by Dianchenko.
Yeah, and we saw that miss yesterday in the second half from Capone as well out there. A very aggressive forward out there, really lost how to find himself in available spots, and a room missed chance there for FCT, unfortunately.
Samoas unable to collect that ball coming through, and we'll see our first look at Isaiah Reed coming onto the floor for FCT. And we mentioned, Chris, that game yesterday in which they lost 9-3 makes this an absolute must-win for FCT if they want to stay in competition here and then hope for a Sporting Outlaws victory against Olympia later on this afternoon.
Well, being a three-team competition, they lost yesterday. If they do lose today, they will be first eliminated, and Saskatchewan will play Quebec later on today at 6 p.m., which, of course, you can catch right here on Canada Soccer's YouTube channel.
Samoa's pushed to the outside, trying to get Reed, stretching through as Capone, but it goes out of play.
Yeah, and FCT really starting to press now, utilizing their experience and their rotations to really kind of navigate around this big Saskatchewan defense out there, and they're getting some key opportunities, and they're going to need to shut that down over at Olympia if they want to make sure they contain.
Capone comes back in the counter and then pushed off the foot there of Capone. Was that touch there from Fitzroy Christie, so that'll be a possession, and they'll come back to Dianchenko. Looks forward, goes back to Christie. Inside to Tomchuk, now Christie at the top, and trying to send it through to Berendica, who puts his hand up, indicating a good ball there from Christie, but unable to make the move there in time, make that Baranek Vasily. Inbound will come on that far side from DeMarco, gets it across to Reed. Reed bearing down in Salatsidis. DeMarco flips up over top, Reed collects. Trying to get it back to Capone or to DeMarco, goes to the number 19 of FCT. Now across to Capone. Capone checks down for Samoas, intercepted by Tomchuk. Great job defensively that time from DeMarco. And they come back in the counter with numbers, trying to get it through to Capone. It'll be touched to the outside. But great job by one of the better players in this tournament, Matias DeMarco.
He's definitely one of the best players in the country, and that's why national team coach Kit Salidopoulos selected him for the Canadian team that defeated the Americans at the CONCACAF qualifiers last May.
So Baranek Vasily gets the clearance attempt off of DeMarco, but the referee right there to make the call, saying it last went off of Olympia. So DeMarco will take the inbound. We got some size in. They got Reed, Capone, and Samoas. And also have David Camposano calling for it at the back end as he's outside of his arc. A couple of switches for Olympia. They come far side, a wasted opportunity that time from DeMarco as he gets it across to Reed, and now Reed's down on the deck. Battling for the ball, going out of bounds, and Reed gets a hand in the face. As Salatsidis on that far side. And we'll see if they take not enough for an injury timeout, but see what the call is. Again, another off-the-ball contact as Reed took a hand up in the face as Salatsidis was going after the ball to inbound it quickly.
Yeah, it's going to take a lot more to get the 20-year-old kid from Scarborough out of the game. I've been watching him for years out there develop in the Toronto and Spanish leagues, and he's a real, real good key player, but he's also a great character off the court as well. Always works hard, always polite to people, shaking hands, and definitely one of the best haircuts in this tournament, I can say.
The inbound will come on that far side from Olympia, but it's intercepted by DeMarco, plays it back to Camposano, now to Samoas. Good square ball across to DeMarco, who's got a bit of space to work with. Good pressure up top, though, from Olympia, leads to a turnover, but unable to collect cleanly there was Jay Tomchuk. Calling for it is Reed, and he'll get it. Reed, move to the inside. Looking for help, and Reed gets intercepted. Here's a 3-on-2. Back the other way. Tomchuk, shot release. Good save, Camposano. Deflects out for a corner kick as Reed takes responsibility for that defensive miscue.
That was a hard shot there by Olympia, but David Camposano certainly up to the task, positioned himself very well, make the stop.
Reed marking up inside on the corner kick, comes back to the back end. Baranek Vasily taken down hard by Capone. And that's a clear call to make. The referee right there to make it. And it'll be a free kick upcoming now for Olimpia.
That was a great job there by Vasily to draw the foul out there. Very aggressive, big bulldog type of player trying to get down the sideline and drawing the foul. Something you want to make sure you get over here in futsal. For those new to the sport, each team is allocated 5 fouls per half. Anything above it, unopposed 10-meter shot on the keeper.
Shot from Vasily, gets good contact on it into BC in the way. I think goes off of his back and then cleared out of play on the attack outside from Tomchuk. Capone stretches up top to Kovacevic, and it's 2-1 FCT. Put inside by Reed as it goes off the post, but built up there. Kovacevic in on the play once again.
And that's one of the most important tactics out there in futsal to make sure you master is finding that far post out there. And that's something this experienced side from Toronto has been able to utilize time and time again over the years. And ultimately, they find that result and now find themselves up for the first time in the competition.
Held there by Tomchuk, and they'll come back into Dianchenko. It was across. Christie going to leave that one, but gets it right back. Fitzroy Christie battling with Capone. Trying to make a move out of the back is Tomchuk. He's got some help to work with. Christie, good off the ball movement again to make himself available. And DeBisi lays it back. Shot. Good contact on it from Jerson Berendika, but not on target and goes wide of the net.
Certainly. Well, if they have any ambitions of beating a keeper of the high caliber that David Camposano brings to the table, they're certainly going to want to make sure that they're not taking shots about 20 meters out. They got to get right up close in the crease and make sure they're firing point blank in order to make sure they get back into this game and tie it up.
Samoas gains the offensive zone. Chips it into the corner. DeMarco lays it back off of Rodriguez, who makes good contact. But it's a big save at the other end from Dianchenko, up to the task after a save at the other end from his counterpart in Camposano. Chip comes forward, trying to keep it in as Christie, but lays it right off for Hurtigay. Rodriguez going to slow it down, gives it to DeMarco, the floor general. DeMarco to the outside to Rodriguez, trying to break through this high three press up top. And Camposano going to come up and keep it in the offensive zone for FCT. Gets a shot away. Great shot, Camposano. And I think it went off the hands and then off the post. This could be a corner kick. We'll see what the referee makes the call, and it will be, Chris.
Yeah, Camposano saw an opportunity out there, went right to the center court and just took a blast and just almost buried it out there to give them a two-goal lead. Great job there by the goalkeeper.
And it's certainly a big factor to think about is having the goalkeeper play into the offensive strategy, and Camposano does a great job of it there. Something we should watch out for the rest of this game and perhaps into the rest of the tournament is getting the goalkeepers more involved in the offensive scheme.
Well, certainly, and Canada definitely has the reputation in CONCACAF for producing some of the best two-footed goalkeepers and attacking goalkeepers in all of futsal out there. Obviously, David Camposano we're seeing here with Futsal Club Toronto being one, and Toronto United, Josh Lamos, his teammate on the Canadian national team, another as well. And both these keepers know how to utilize both their feet, left and right. So to come out as an attacker to utilize this, it just adds such a dimension out there that it's very difficult to contain, especially for an inexperienced side such as Olimpia.
And we just saw, again, Camposano getting involved in the corner kick. It'll come back. Jorge has it in the defensive zone. Comes it right back into Rodriguez. Jorge at the top. Makes a move around into BC. Kovacevic up top. Gets past the foot of Tomchuk, but it's just squeaking out of bounds. Much to the dismay there of Kovacevic trying to argue the case, saying it needs to be the full ball, but I think the official well aware of the rules here, Chris.
Yeah, and you know what? Olimpia was fortunate out there because Tomchuk decided to pinch and he got burned on it. And, you know, fortunately for Olimpia in that circumstance, the ball went out of bounds. Otherwise, there could have been a real nasty scoring opportunity there for Futsal Club Toronto.
Rodriguez gets it in off the quick inbound from DeMarco. Now Jorge goes far side. DeMarco, he's got Rodriguez to his left, but they go inside to Jorge. He's got Kovacevic now. Good ball movement from FCT right now, creating a lot of space. Flick to the inside, but right there, Fitzroy Christie coming across. Not going to allow FCT any offensive momentum on that drive through.
What an athletic specimen the guy is. He has been a stalwart in the futsal community for the last 10 to 15 years out there, depending on FIFA and the old FIFUSA system as well. And it's just unbelievable to think that he is 35. I can't get over how athletic this guy is. Quite possibly the most athletic guy on the court out there.
Inbound coming in now from FCT. Kovacevic looking for it on the far side. They go to DeMarco instead. Kovacevic going to try to post up in on Christie. DeMarco Now to Rodriguez, battling with NDBC, and that's a battle you're not going to win too often. Huge frame from NDBC, but good feet to boot. They go into Tomchuk. It's going to roll out, and it'll be possession to Olimpia. That's a huge man out there as NDBC.
Oh, he's absolutely massive. I was down courtside talking to him before the game. Originally from Nigeria, the man's an absolute beast and a half. And you can see him in that post-up position. They can get him the ball. He can use those long legs out there to try and spin and get an attempt on target.
And Tomchuk looking for that ball to come inside. They go to Berendika instead. Now Tomchuk again. Good foot movement there from him. Lays it off for Christie, but can't get back in time, as Kovacevic was there to make a difference, and it's inside to Ndibisi. Great hold by him, and tries to pull it back inside. Lays it off for Tomchuk. And a wasted opportunity there. Ndibisi lays it off for Tomchuk, and now he'll make his way to the bench and give way at the back end to Abumiri Okonafoa.
And his... because his size is, you know, he's a 6'2", big bruising guy out there. His footwork still needs a little bit of, you know, assistance out there. He's got that soccer background out there, so he's making the transition to futsal. So, you know, you can see the movement from the more experienced players in futsal, left foot, right foot, bottom of the foot, etc. So he's going to have to adapt out there in order to really make an impact against an experienced side in Toronto.
And somebody with great touch on both sides of his feet there, with Fitzroy Christie collecting on the near side, trying to send it into Okonafua. Lays it off for Ndibisi, but it's intercepted, but it'll be quickly come back the other way, and it's a good poke through on the toe. Looking for a foul call was Berendika, but not going to get it.
That was a valiant attempt out there. He saw an opportunity, tried to take it, but Camposano not really giving him much to look at there at the net.
Rodriguez turns the ball over, trying to get it up top to Kovacevic, but unable to do so. Ndibisi turns to the inside as he gets taken down on the far side by Smith. And it'll be Rodriguez inbounding on the far side for FCT. Score remains 2-1 in favor of Futsal Club Toronto. But again, in futsal, that lead can change very, very quickly, as we saw a number of times yesterday. The goals filling up in the first half for the Sporting Outlaws, who are ecstatic with the way things finished yesterday in a 9-3 victory. And another save there from Camposano as FCT tries to come back in the counter. As it gets passed on the far side, Smith still with it, is Smith. Can't poke it through, and it's a save wisely there. But now Christie will try to come back, and another save from Dianchenko.
Yeah, Olimpia were very fortunate there not to get caught and get a big attempt from Quani Abbott Hill Smith, a very athletic guy in his own right out there. And very fortunate, Olimpia still only down 2-1 right now.
And Ndibisi turns it over, but Kovacevic going to slow it down and lay it back off for Rodriguez. Hirage gains center court, but he'll drop it right back for Rodriguez. Okay. Rodriguez again. Stretch ball comes to the top to Kovacevic, who's guarded by Christie. Kovacevic still with it, using his strength to push Christie off the ball. Kovacevic looking for some movement. They go to Rodriguez. Poke downside to DeMarco. DeMarco in the corner, cuts it back, but Christie able to clear it out. Now it's an odd man rush the other way. Here's a 2-on-1. Now it's back. Kovacevic does a great job getting back to help out. Cuts down the angle nicely and makes it an easy save for Camposano.
Benedica did a great job out there trying to get on the sideline, get that toe punt, which is something, you know, you tell kids never to do in soccer. But over here in futsal, it's a dynamic weapon that you absolutely must master. And Camposano up to the task to prevent the Saskatchewan native from tying this game up.
Samoa's back onto the floor for FCT, and he has the ball. Lays it off for Hirge. Go down to Smith. Almost gets a nice break there, but goes off the foot of Abumiri Okonafua, and it'll be a corner kick for FCT.
Toronto there was looking. We saw the opportunity that Brandon Samoj had. He was finding himself in open territory. The ball just couldn't get to his foot, though.
Rodriguez, great ball through, unopposed, and Samoas kind of shaking his head there, an opportunity to make it 3-1.
Second opportunity again. He's found himself in open space. He's doing a great job out there. The young kid trying to make sure that he puts his team up and really, really swing the momentum even further.
They're going to say that Christie had his foot on the line. The ball wasn't completely out, so it's going to be a turnover deep in the offensive zone. So we'll see if FCT can take advantage. Smith going to inbound the ball. Got a couple of tall and big options to work with in front, including Rodriguez, or make that Samoas, who's got the ball now. Samoas lays it off for Reed. Now Samoas again, trying to get past Tomchuk. Now it's Salatsidis coming back, lays it off. Tomchuk poke through, can't get it loose, and that's another big save. Campesano flicks it up for Reed. Reed with speed down the left wing. Reed gets it in across, trying to get it into the corner to Smith, but can't quite get it there as Christie lays it back for Tomchuk, now for Olimpia. Tomchuk. Here is Christie. Fitzroy Christie. Has to get around Samoas. Now Salatsidis makes a move around Hyurge, but it's going to go out of play. And Reed will collect in the defensive half for FCT. Score remains 2-1 for Futsal Club Toronto, the Ontario champions. Battling here with Olimpia, but it's a turnover. Here's Tomchuk. Tomchuk just wide of the net. Could have tied things up at two as he sends his up into the stands. And it remains at one goal lead. Fitzroy Christie collects the ball in the defensive end. Tomchuk, ball comes across. Here is Vitkovsky. Andre Vitkovsky gets the ball back and unable to get a clean look as it goes off his foot and out of play. But good movement by Olimpia trying to play their way back into this game.
You know, a lot of people thought Saskatchewan coming into this tournament weren't going to compete with the big dogs from Quebec, the big dogs from Ontario. But the reality is they're very athletic out there in the prairies. A great soccer tradition and history from the Saskatchewan Soccer Association, as we see the foul called against the big 6'1" Tomchuk from Saskatoon. But the reality is you have a great coach in Jaime Meza. He's one of the best in the country, hands down, tactically. Trained with Fernando Ferretti down in Brazil, who won a World Cup with the Brazilian national team. And he can take these experienced players, as we see a card coming out to Matias DeMarco. That's the last guy FCT wants to see get a card, because he's a fantastic player out there on the national team, but he's a leader of this squad. And hopefully he can calm down that frustration. But going back to Saskatchewan, we see the development of their soccer program coming up out there, but their futsal definitely is going to be swinging huge momentum in the years to come, so a wonderful job by the SSA.
Vitkovsky able to play it out, goes off the foot there of Reed. Tomchuk in the inbound, trying to post up. It's a good idea there from Olimpia, but not reading it was Andre Vitkovsky. Now the ball comes back the other way into the offensive zone for Reed, gets touched out by Tomchuk. And now we'll see Campesano coming back into the offensive zone as Olimpia makes a switch. Baranek Vasily comes back onto the floor for the yellow. Reed comes back to DeMarco. DeMarco goes far side to Smith. Gets it back as Smith. Great stretch through, and it's a save at the back end from Dianchenko. Christie lays it up for Vasily. Baranek Vasily shot just wide of the far post.
That was a solid attempt there. I like the battle between Hugo Rodriguez and Fitzroy Christie out there.
We're going to get a timeout upcoming. We'll see if it's FCT or Olimpia calling the timeout. But again, DeMarco getting a little bit frustrated. We saw that a little bit yesterday, Chris, and getting upset, getting his second yellow card in as many games as DeMarco kicks that ball away after a time call warning on the free kick back the other way. And under 7 minutes to go here in the first half, it remains 2-1.
Yeah, no, with Matias DeMarco out there, the 28-year-old native of Brampton, has been an absolute stalwart in the Toronto and Ontario futsal scene and got discovered by Kitsilodopoulos at the open tryouts not even open, actually, they were invite. When you get the top talent out there, he was one of the top picks, and everyone has been very impressed with him. However, sometimes he does have a tendency to kind of get a little heated. He's a very passionate guy out there. He loves this sport. He loves the game big, and sometimes that can get the better of him. So let's just hope for his sake that he can contain that and not get ejected, because it would be a big loss to see him miss that final.
So 5:48 left to go here in the opening half. Futsal Club Toronto has 2, and Olimpia from Saskatchewan has 1. They get the game's opening goal, 2 unanswered so far for FCT. And now we see DeMarco, who we were just speaking about, getting pretty vocal in the huddle, trying to get things cleared up, talking with Samoas, among others. But again, FCT in a decent position right now with the lead. And all they really need to worry about at the moment is securing that victory to ensure that they have a chance to make it to Sunday's final.
And what happens here is if FCT wins, Saskatchewan has a must-win scenario against Quebec later on today at 6 o'clock that you and I will be calling on the YouTube channel here at Canada Soccer.
DeMarco with great body movement there to prevent Tomchuk from getting a touch on the ball. And it'll stay with FCT with a corner kick upcoming. DeMarco waiting for some help, goes far side to Kovacevic. Good control there from him. They go back far side, Samoas. And it'll go off the foot of Salatsidis and will be an inbound from Samoas up top for FCT. Lays it back to Samoas. And a great dummy at the back end from Tomchuk, and DeMarco unable to get there in time and wins a goal kick upcoming. Flicked up there by Berendika as the pace picks up here. Here's Kovacevic. It's a bit of a lane to shoot through. Goes to the far side instead to DeMarco. Back to Samoas. In tight to Reed. Reed trying to make the move through, and it'll be FCT possession deep in the offensive zone on the sideline. And it's wasted that time from Reed trying to get it back to Samoas, but goes right out of play as you see Tomchuk putting pressure in as each team's respective number nine doing a great battle here in the late part of the first half.
And to see DeMarco just looking behind him, making sure that Salatsidis isn't getting behind him to find that empty open space.
Deep stretch, Paul Salatsidis makes contact, I believe, and Campesano right there to read it nicely and clears it out of harm's reach. Comes back to the back end, Berenik Vasily. Gets that stretch ball up top, handled nicely by Salatsidis, but couldn't find the ball. Samoas trying to add to this lead for FCT. Great ball inside from Kovacevic. Back to Kovacevic. And now a counter for Vasily.
Salatsidis, the important man to come back there.
Toe poke, they come through, and Dianchenko trips up Reed, but inadvertent contact, and that's going to be a goal kick clearance. No, they're going to call it a corner instead, saying Dianchenko made contact with the ball.
Dianchenko, great reflexes out there. The 37-year-old native of Saskatoon really doing a solid job here in the first half.
Check ball comes back. It'll be touched off again by Olimpia. That'll be another corner for FCT. So I got Reed inside the arc, trying to create some havoc inside. Makes a cut back and then moves forward, but I'm not. DeMarco pushes it through and nobody there to handle for FCT. Here is Christie back on the floor. And we'll take the inbound on that far side. Now Samoas getting vocal, getting frustrated with the lack of communication on his team. Kovacevic collects and gets that great ball to come through. Unable to collect, but here is Reed. Gets it on the second try through. Kovacevic trying to get it to the outside to Samoas. Now in the counter, Kovacevic coming back to help out DeMarco. It's handled by Tomchuk and now intercepted again. Here's Reed. Goes to Samoas and it's poked loose at the last second there by Berenik Vasily.
I have no idea what Tomchuk was thinking there, just putting the little back heel over to find nobody. And FCT almost able to counterattack out there and go up on a 3-1 scoreline.
DeMarco making a move inside, battling with Christie. But Kovacevic has it at the top and will leave it for Reed. Reed on the far side. Got Samoas to work with, and that's where they go in the square ball. Samoas inside to Reed. Tries to turn to the outside, but instead will come back to DeMarco. Here is Samoas. And Berenik Vasily right in the way. He's going to get a yellow card now. Not getting back in time and giving ample opportunity and space for Samoas to inbound.
That was a quick yellow card there by referee Alexis Vaughn. Usually you have to give the 5 meters out there, but you know, he decided to come in and interfere on that. But usually you get a warning in that scenario. So we're going to have to see Vasily out there, make sure that he watches himself. One of the more experienced players out here, 32 years of age for Olimpia FC.
Flick comes inside, and instead of catching, just going to clear it through with the swat was Dianchenko. And I think Vasily knew full well needed to give some space up, and that's a tactic sometimes to implore for the opposition, and it's a push inside. Here's Reed just out of his reach. Dianchenko sliding across to make sure there was no contact made there on that offensive sequence. Christie gets it back off the inbounds. And now they have numbers forward. Here's Fitzroy Christie. Good movement, big save, Campesano. And Christie had an opportunity to take the shot there, and Vasily gets taken down hard. That's going to be a foul on FCT. And again, Christie frustrated on that far side with Berenik Vasily. And I think Christie perhaps a little bit distraught that he had made the decision not to shoot there.
Well, I like the fact that Vasily took a big blast out there. Campesano well positioned. But what I really enjoyed there was seeing Vasily come back after the rebound, fight for it, and earn this free kick opportunity out there. So great hustle by the young kid from Saskatchewan.
So Berendika and Vasily trying to set up. We'll see who makes contact. Looks as though it's going to be Berendika. Two in the wall, and then Christie inside. Berendica just going to blast one through, but it's wide of the net. And the hands go up in frustration there from Vasily. A little bit disappointed with how that unfolded. Campusano just going to lay it forward, and back onto the floor is Hodegay. Up top, Kovacevic with the left foot trying to get it across. Hodegay not there in time. And now communication from Berendica to the sideline. Trying to figure out a game plan the next time through. Here is Christie. Vasily intercepted. Tom Chuck there. And now Ortel just going to clear it out of the side.
I like the rotations being led here by Christie, but Tom Chuck seems to be out of place up front, not knowing where to be.
Go to the outside to Christie, who gets it right back from Vasily. As Vasily now has it on the far sideline. Getting defended there by Ortel. Now Christie again. Fitzroy Christie looking for some help. Instead goes to the square to Vasily. Now Christie again. Back to Vasily. Can't quite get there in time. As Olimpia continues to trail here in the late stages of the first half, it's still 2-1 FCT.
That's fantastic. Nice tight game going back and forth. Great opportunities on both sides out here. And this is exactly what futsal is all about, Kyle.
Tomchuk putting pressure in up top on Hodegay. Capone back out there now, and here is Smith. Smith lays it off for Capone. Can't get the check ball back in, and Capone goes hard down to the floor. Perhaps trying to sell a foul call, but knows he's not going to get it there. Dianchenko pushes that ball forward, plays it off the chest, and gets it right back is Tomchuk to Salatsidis. Trying to get around Capone, and he will, but Capone using that strength to get right back in and wins the sideline touch-in. Great job there by number 21 of FCT.
Solid job. Capone, we saw yesterday, he's one of the hardest working players on this team out there. He's a bulldog. He just loves to be involved in the action, and he always, always is going forth and coming back to make sure that he covers his bases, and I love watching that fantastic two-way style.
Flick comes inside. It's a good ball from Ortel. Nobody there on the receiving end as Smith can't get there in time. Christie, inbounds. Tight pressure in up top, but unable to get it loose. There was Tomchuk intercepted by Hurge. And now Capone plays it forward. Ortel, great move to the inside. Ortel scores! What a great job inside by Marcello Ortel.
Marcel Ortel, just one of the more experienced players coming out of the Ontario scene. Been playing futsal since he was 6-7 years old out there, and he just made a great job showing his experience rolling that ball and bringing a 2-goal lead up to his squad. Great job by the 30-year-old.
Late stages here of the first half. It is now 3-1 for Futsal Club Toronto. They've already equaled their goal total from yesterday against the Sporting Outlaws, and a big respond effort here from them as they try to head into the half with that 2-goal cushion to perhaps add some more, but Salatsidis tries to answer to that.
Hey, two big shot attempts out there from Olimpia. We saw a little bit more of kind of their dynamic and futsal tactics going out there, trying to find that far post, but FCT holding strong there at the back.
We're going to get another timeout here as Olimpia going to take their timeout as, again, now we're seeing Eduardo Hyurge coming over to the huddle and trying to discuss things with his teammates, frustrated with that last couple of offensive attempts there from Olimpia. But Olimpia not going to go down easily. Again, we've seen FCT come back in a must-win game for them, and they've responded nicely after yesterday's loss, leading 3-1. But Olimpia not going to roll over here by any means, Chris, and they still have plenty of time to get themselves back in. If not at the end of this half, still have 20 minutes in the second half.
You know, people will watch soccer and say, oh, 3-1 lead. Wow, it's, you know, very, very difficult to kind of come back from. But the reality of the situation is futsal has a higher amount of goals per game. The average amount of goals is just over 7.5 per match out there. So a 2-goal lead with this stop clock is absolutely nothing. You can score 2 goals literally within a 10 to 20-second span out there. And Olimpia, you know, they're not as experienced, but their athleticism and their heart and tenacity out there, we've already seen it here in the first half. A very, very strong side and very promising future year to come for this Saskatchewan futsal program.
Olimpia getting the first goal of the game in the opening couple of minutes on the first shot on David Campusano. Gets a piece of it, but squeaks through. And then it's been three back the other way, unanswered for FCT, and they hold that 3-1 lead. And again, to the late stages here of the first half. Here is Christie at the top. Fitzroy Christie. Goes inside to Salatsidis. Off the ball move there from Christie. Trying to lay it off on that far side. Posting it up top. onto the floor now for the first time is Tiago Prado for Olimpia. Salatsidis. Prado moving in up top. Salatsidis trying to get the flick back from Berendica, but that goes out of play, and now he's trying to communicate with Tiago Prado in terms of where they're going to set up defensively. Hyorge to Capone. Capone to Smith. Now far side to Reed, but tries to get it through. Dianchenko there to collect. Dianchenko, stretch ball up top, trying to get it up top to Christie, and that's going to be a foul on Salatsidis. Going to make that Berendica, and a good free kick opportunity inside now for Olimpia.
There's it. There's not too much time left on the clock, just actually apparently 2 minutes underneath out there, and that's the fourth foul out there for FCT. And as we mentioned, each team is allowed 5 fouls per half. Every single foul in that half that goes over 5 results in that unopposed 10-meter shot on the goalkeeper as we see that second white dot just north of the crease.
So still 2 fouls to give to get into that situation here for FCT, so have to be feeling comfortable, but they have to be able to bar down in the defensive zone to make sure that they don't commit any unnecessary fouls and give that opportunity for Olimpia to play their way back in here in the late stages of the first half.
There's a big opportunity for Olimpia out there. Let's see if they're able to capitalize on a set play.
Looks as though Prado going to set up to take the free kick. He's got options. He's got Tomchuk to the left. And here is Prado, just skies it. Trying to get the toe poke there. And Chris, that wasn't even close.
No, that would be great if you were in the NFL kicking a field goal from 40 yards out. But certainly out here, he got way too under that ball and placed it up there.
Here comes Hyorge. Trying to come back and add to the lead in the final few minutes here as Capone gets a little jersey tug in there on Prado. Tomchuk, there's a move back inside, lays it off for Christie. Christie battling with Smith, and Christie wins that one, but is in the defensive half. They go across, intercepted. Here's a chance to add to it. And unable to collect their Reed with a great interception, but Smith can't finish.
Olimpia getting away with one there. Last thing they want to do is go down 3 goals at half. If they can keep it to 3-1, it's going to be better for their confidence going in.
Here's Camposano joining the fray up top. Has to be careful and has to drop back in time. Make sure he doesn't get chipped or gets lost in a counter.
Yeah, Olimpia's got to be more composed. They got to be more relaxed with how they're coming out here. They're sitting there with just about a minute 13 left on the clock. They want to make sure they can sit down, cool it, go back into the halftime out there with Coach Jaime Meza and make sure they can readjust their game plan accordingly.
Here's Smith in the near corner, looking for some help streaking in, but he's defended nicely there by Fitzroy Christie, a name we've said a bunch here in this opening half and will likely continue throughout the rest of the day. Who's inside? Smith. There is DeMarco. They come back to Hyorge. Great shot through, but it goes off the leg of Tomchuk. Keeping pressure in up top is Capone. That's going to be a foul on number 21 of FCT. And the horn goes, I think, inadvertently there as the play continuing on.
And they fouled out officially, so every foul FCT does for the next minute will result in that. So there will be minimal contact coming from the boys in blue as we come into the last minute of the first half.
Christie.
Perhaps trying for Christie to sell it. Experienced guy like that.
Perhaps trying to entice a foul here would be the wise move if you are Olimpia. And played up from the back end there from Marcos Henderson. But here comes FCT. Check to the inside, score! Great move inside there by Capone to find a streaking Smith. 4-1 FCT.
That was a big mistake there by Olimpia, sitting there trying to head the ball to nobody that was there, and they just got caught on a 3v2. And that was the one mistake they did not want to make in the last minute, especially getting their opposition to foul out there. So if they can manage to pull one back, they'll be happy, but they're going to be regretting that going into the locker room.
So it's now gone from a 2-3 goal lead now for FCT in the dying moments here of the opening half, and it's another turnover this time from Christie. Smith has it at the top. They come across to DeMarco, trying to use help. And they'll play it back wisely to Camposano to create some space. Hyorge goes in up top to Capone, but it's intercepted by Henderson, who will drop back in and try to defend and keep this now at a 3-goal lead for the Ontario champions. And the attack inside, Hyorge unable to get anyone on the receiving end, and he'll have to drop back in. And that'll do it for the opening half. And Chris, a great job to push through there. Four straight goals unanswered. FCT leads 4-1 after the opening goal from Olimpia. What did you see there in the opening half from FCT to counter after giving up and conceding that early first goal?
Well, they sat there, they remained composed, they navigated the ball, rotated properly. Camposano was an absolute rock in net, so any opportunities that Olimpia had, they didn't really have much to shoot at to begin with, and Camposano was there as the solid guy to make sure to give the confidence to the guys to deliver. But most importantly, FCT was coming out, finding the back post, making sure that they were exposing this more inexperienced Olimpia side and navigating, and as a result, they walk into the second half now with a three-goal lead.
Now, if you're heading into the second half for Meza Castillo's team, what do you have to do if you are Olimpia to try to play your way back in and get under the skin here of FCT and claw your way back in on the scoreboard as well?
Well, they're definitely going to want to play more aggressive. They're going to want to utilize their size out there, not in a defensive format, but they're going to push up for, you know, further up here. Their two defenders are sitting right behind the center line out there, and you got to come out and press, especially you're down three goals. Will we see a fifth attacker like Toronto was pulling yesterday against Sporting Outlaws? You're going to have to see a little more of that in the last 3-4 minutes of the second half, having seen Jaime Meza Castillo coach and how his system works. But if they don't press up immediately from the get-go in the second half, it could be a long day for the Saskatchewan boys.
So at the moment, it is a must-win situation here for the Futsal Club Toronto if they want an opportunity to play in tomorrow's final. They lead 4-1 at the half against the Saskatchewan champions Olimpia Saskatoon. Join us back here for the second half in a few moments' time. You're watching the 2017 Futsal Canadian Championship here at Queen's University. Join us back for the second half.
Good half. It's all right.
Welcome back to the Athletics and Recreation Center on the campus of Queen's University in Kingston, Ontario. You're joining us for the 2017 Futsal Canadian Championship. Kyle Compo joined alongside by Chris Fernandez. And Chris, it is a 4-1, three-goal lead for FCT in this must-win game. The second game day, and second game overall for our round robin. And we'll see what happens here in the second half. Olimpia trying to come back from that three-goal deficit.
Definitely, and you know they have the right coach to try and adapt to this game plan that Toronto has imposed on them. And ultimately, they're going to really need to come out and attack if they want to get right back in this.
Tomchuk plays the ball quickly out to the far side, gets Jerson Berendika involved. Tomchuk still with it, getting pressured by Smith, and it's intercepted, but Tomchuk able to turn and collect, and it's a good move forward. Pass to the inside. Here is Vasily. Vasily, shot, score! What a start to the second half for Olimpia.
Well, I don't know what Jaime Meza Castillo told them, but they said, obviously, be more aggressive as we see the old Rob Van Dam thumbs going for number 11, Baranek Vasily, the 32-year-old Saskatoon native, bringing his team now within two right off the get-go.
4-2 the score. So Baranek Vasily answers the call right away as a blistering shot beats Campesano, and it's a turnover right again out of the defensive zone for FCT. So we'll see what Olimpia can do here in the early stages of the second half as it's touched back there and push forward. Now it's losing a spot on the floor. I think slipping up a little bit there was Jay Tomchuk, and now it's intercepted. Here comes Smith. Can Smith answer the call and get it right back? Good challenge in there, and we'll see. Here comes Baranek Vasily. Vasily trying to add to it again as it was touched out of bounds, but good patience at the back end there by Fitzroy Christie, and it's a corner one for Olimpia. And just skied out of the back that time from Jerson Berendika. But good start to the second half here for Olimpia.
We definitely can't go wrong getting that goal in the first minute. Really get the confidence out there for the boys in yellow.
And posting in up top there was Kovacevic. Smith looking for Kovacevic again. Goes back to the point there to DeMarco instead. And it's a counter back the other way. Here comes Tomchuk. Tomchuk trying to lay it off and get it across to Berendika, but can't get it there in time. Make that Vasily, who was stretching it up top, Berendika here on the near side.
Well, I'm really looking forward to this battle with Kokakovic and Fitzroy Christie out there. Kokakovic really making some great space out there for himself. An impact player, very simple.
Hjortage down the left wing, gets a great pass in there from Kokakovic. And up to the task at the back end, Alex Dianchenko with a big save there for Olimpia, but it's a corner one for FCT, and they're going to have to do it again.
And it was a solid save out there by the Olympic keeper, Dianchenko.
DeMarco chips it in up top, goes off the head of Kovacevic inside, and it's going to be a play here for Dianchenko as a last touched out by FCT.
We talked about Dianchenko earlier on. He's one of the oldest players in this tournament at 37 years of age.
Way back in, Smith has fouled hard. And Vasily coming in and cleaning out Smith on that hard challenge. But Vasily and Smith kind of embracing after, showing a sign of sportsmanship there. DeMarco getting into the offensive zone, but battling with Tomchuk. Now DeMarco framing the body. It's an advantage call out now from the official. Tomchuk shot, and it's a save from Campesano, but good crack there from the number 9 in yellow.
That's a big boot from the Prairie Boy out there. I wouldn't want to be in net taking that big boot from the 31-year-old who's actually celebrating his birthday, turning 32 next week.
Cleared out of the back end.
Great birthday gift that would be if he could get back into this game and salvage a point and possibly even take full points against this Ontario base side.
DeMarco holding in the defensive zone, trying to get it through to Rodriguez, and it goes out of play. So a tough start with possession, and that's going to pull Samoas back onto the floor here for FCT. Vasily drops it to the point. Tomchuk goes across to Christie. Move inside. Berendika trying to get around Samoas, but a tough task at hand at any point on the floor, let alone on that tight sideline. Rodriguez comes inside. Passes it through to Hjortage. Samoas. And just going to let it through and come through. Was Ndibisi. And Dianchenko will play it forward to Vasily. Was off the foot there of Kovacevic. Vasily chips it in up top into BC battling with Rodriguez. Here's Samoas. Got Kovacevic inside. Samoas still with it. And to make the move, but it's defended nicely again by Christie. Fitzroy Christie. Good poise with the body. Now it's odd man rush the other way. Here comes Olimpia. Shot from Vasily. No, lays it off. Inside, Berendika scores! 4-3. What a start to the second half.
What a dream start here for Olimpia. They really got hyped up in that dressing room, to say the least. Not too many teams sitting there facing that 4-1 deficit are going to come out guns a-blazing like these guys have. And already, only a few minutes in the second half, and they're down by a single goal against one of the top teams out here in the country.
Here is Capone on the far side, battling with Ndibisi. Last touched out by Olimpia. Hirge at the top. Goes across to Rodriguez. Hirge, stretch ball comes in up top, trying to get Capone, and Ndibisi just going to clear it out. Not allow FCT with an opportunity to get a shot through. Hirge pulls it back into the defensive half. Campusano going to play his way up into the offensive zone. It's played back. They got to be careful. And Ndibisi plays it forward. But Campusano getting back there in time but unable to handle it was Fitzroy Christie.
And Christie looks like he's favoring that left knee out there after taking a knock at center court. He'll probably shake it off knowing the athlete that he is.
And Ndibisi getting taken out as Capone able to get to the ball first. Capone down the right wing. A hard foul by Vasily. Could this be a yellow card upcoming?
We'll see Toronto native Alexis Vaughn, the first referee of the match out here. I remember still watching her take her course about 3-4 years ago out there and seeing her move all the way to the national championships, handling these boys, making sure that nothing gets out of hand.
Now DeMarco coming in as the extra attacker. We saw this yesterday, Chris. FCT perhaps feeling the pressure, only up by a single goal right now, trying to add to their goal tally in case of a potential goal difference that could come into play later on this evening as they take on the Sporting Outlaws. So DeMarco out there trying to add to it and get some offensive pressure. Great stretch through as DeMarco will make his way to the bench quickly and allow Campusano to make his way back in.
Yeah, definitely that 4-1 was looking a lot better on paper out there, especially since we know that Sporting Outlaws of Quebec are going to be playing Saskatchewan later, 6 o'clock tonight.
And DeBisi with a hard shot. And Chris, we saw that game. It was a 9-3 final for Sporting Outlaws. So they're plus 6 right now in goal difference. So if it comes down to a tiebreak and they perhaps lose the game and get into that tiebreaking situation later, they're in good shape in the goal difference right now.
And not to take anything away from Saskatchewan, but I think looking at it right now, the Outlaws who are in the crowd right across from us now, they would prefer very much to play the more inexperienced Saskatchewan boys as opposed to the Toronto guys who have been here before. And ultimately, they're going to want to sit there and navigate.
Intercepted by Christie, and DeBisi keeps it in the offensive third. And it's poked through. Christie trying to get it loose and will drop it to the back end. And they get the shot through from Okonafua. Okonafua still with it. Now it's intercepted.
Oh, big mistake there.
Here comes Capone, unable to get a clean shot look, and it goes well wide of that far post. As Dianchenko just going to play it forward. And collecting on that far side. Here is Tomchuk. Playing it to the outside. Tomchuk now back inside. Lays it off instead to Okonafua. Tomchuk with it again. Had Vasily to his left, and now Ndibisi just going to play it to the inbound because he's got Dianchenko behind him, but he'll play it short instead to Vasily. Vasily framing with the body and just going to clear it down the floor. It's a good ball up top. It's a good idea to get it up top to Tomchuk, but Vasily just clears it out. Now he's going to come to the bench and give way to Salatsidis.
Yeah, Tomchuk was looking for that one-touch blast off. But in futsal, this low-bounce ball, you just touch the ball, keep it right at your feet, and then see what you can do in a 1v1 situation, especially with his size.
DeMarco looking for the call and looking for Hirge to go down into the corner. Comes back to DeMarco, goes across for Rodriguez. Now down into the corner. DeMarco makes a cut inside. Here's an opportunity for Tomchuk. Open cage, and they score! This game is tied at 4. And FCT giving up 3 in a row.
This is unbelievable stuff from the debutantes out from Saskatoon. Down 4-1 at half, coming back with 3 goals. in not even 5 minutes. This is unbelievable stuff out here from the rookie side. And boy, oh boy, is FCT definitely going to want to come out and utilize that fifth attacker to really try and get this back in their favor.
So we saw again, we saw them use it yesterday, but they were down 7 goals, Chris, and that was an opportunity for them to try to play their way back in and make it more reasonable on the scoreboard. But they were up 4-1 here, and up a goal, they pull the extra attacker at any time that there's a turnover. Not a long court to work with. So Olimpia doing a great job to counter, and this game is tied. Rodriguez down inside to Capone. Well, back into Hurtigay.
Yeah, they're going to definitely want to watch for that far post out there. Like we're seeing right now, five of the best players out here from Ontario on this Toronto line. But the reality of the situation is, they can be contained if Olimpia makes sure that they are watching their far post. And it's easier said than done when you're, you know, getting attacked 5v4. But, boy, oh boy, Olimpia have really thrown the momentum going their way.
So FCT obviously needs to win this game, but they also need to win with a pretty substantial goal difference if they wanted to ensure their spot into Sunday's final. As again, as they anticipate perhaps that Sporting would win later on this evening against this team from Saskatchewan. But if they get the victory, then they're in good shape. So you would have to think that they're going to try to play for the win here, regardless of what the score is. And now they've given up that 3-goal lead and it's tied at 4.
No question. These 3 points are the most valuable of the tournament, without question. Outlaws are sitting cruise control right now in first place out there. But again, their game against Saskatchewan ain't going to be easy, but they certainly bring athleticism and experience for that young side out there. And realistically, we're seeing some desperation right now from Toronto as they come on the 5v4.
Campusano joining the mix instead of DeMarco, and now Campusano forced to get back into his defensive half, and here's a chance. Again, it's a 2-on-0. Here comes Salatsidis. Shot through, shot, score! And who's in the lead now? Olimpia, 5-4.
This is absolute pandemonium here at Queen's University in Kingston. Unbelievable. 4-1 going into halftime. And only minutes into the second, Saskatchewan has come out blazing. This is unreal. This is a freight train that FCT must stop if they have any ambitions of getting into the championship game tomorrow against Quebec.
Now the frustration's continuing to boil over here as you see Hurtigay coming over and speaking with the head coach, trying to articulate his concerns. But Chris, what an absolutely huge change in momentum as it's now the Saskatchewan champs, Olimpia Saskatoon, who are now in the lead, 5-4.
And this is exactly what it's like to have such a quality coach of the caliber of Jaime Meza Castillo, the Colombian-born. We already talked about he was training down in South America, and he was over here in Toronto working with Toronto United as well, before moving up to Saskatoon, starting the league out there with all the great people at the Saskatoon and Saskatchewan federations. And boy, you're seeing the results out here, 5-4, unexpected result. But this is the growth in futsal in this country. We can be world champions at this one day if everybody just adopts this, gets all the kids to play it, and we can see the results. If a team like Saskatchewan, a team like Olimpia, I should say, comes in with a 5-4 lead in the second half against a former national championship team, the world of possibilities for BC, Alberta, the Yukon, the territories, PEI, and every other province out there, it's immeasurable, and we have the opportunity to do it. So anybody watching, no matter where you are, whether you're 6 years old, 60 years old, get involved. Let's build this sport together. More information, check out Canada Soccer, and definitely get involved, and let's see what we can do to build this amazing sport in this even better country.
Four unanswered heading in to that last kickoff here from FCT. And again, what an unbelievable start and turn of events here in the second half. Olimpia taking that 5-4 lead after trailing 4-1 at the half. And they come into BC with that, again, that big frame posting up. Turns on the left and gets the shot through, much to the frustration there of Marcelo Ortel. And for a team like FCT, who was once in cruise control here in the first half, Chris, things have really turned around. And as we said before, that's the beauty of the futsal game.
Yeah, you got to sit there. And, you know, we understood why they were going for the 5v4. We understand, obviously, they want that goal difference big time. But the reality of the situation is they left themselves susceptible to the open nets. And Olimpia, frankly, has just taken advantage.
So the inbound now coming from NDBC. And as Chris mentioned, they have been imploring that extra attacker to try to add some goals to their tally after giving up 2 early on in that second half to make it 4-3. And they're trying to cover all their bases. We understand that. But as Chris said, they left themselves open in the defensive zone, and Olympia's taken full advantage. And it's now 5-4 for the Saskatchewan champs. And it comes to the outside. Here's Campusano. plays it into the corner to Artel, and it's cleared out into BC. And we'll see if Camposano stays in the offensive half. It looks as though he will for the time being.
And you can sit there and see the shock on the faces of the fans.
Toe poke comes through, goes off a leg. As getting in the way of that one was Jerson Berendica, serving as part of the team staff as an assistant coach and player as well. Trying to get the poke through on the far side. Rodriguez comes back. Here's Camposano. Goes right back to the square. Here is Hirge. Go into the corner. Kovacevic. Right back to Hirge, and that's out of play. And another offensive zone turnover. And Kovacevic and Hirge trying to articulate their concerns with each other on that sequence through.
Well, it was solid pressure there by Toronto, but Olimpia is certainly up to the task, and that defensive pressure that they put cost the turnover.
And that ball rolling there on Ndubisi, that's going to be a turnover as it touches that far side on the touchline.
Your planting foot in futsal must at least be on the line or behind it out there, but in that case, his planting foot was fully on the court, which is why the turnover happened.
Hirge goes into the corner to Ortel. Square ball here now from Camposano. He's got a lane to shoot through. Great crack from Camposano as it goes wide of the net, and Dianchenko making sure that had no touch to come in on goal. Dianchenko going to play the ball long through the air. Collected nicely off the chest there from Tomchuk. And now Ndubisi muscling guys off the ball. Ndubisi turns over. Here's Kovacevic.
Yeah, the ball way too long there. Way too long and out there. Almost cost a 3v2 attack. He's got to make sure that he's sitting on the ball, stand on it, use that size, that big man out there not doing that job, and he's got to make sure he's watching that against this experienced Toronto side.
We go back to Hirge and that miscommunication again from Ortel as Hirge's ball dribbles out of bounds. And now Fitzroy Christie, an inbound stretch ball. It's just a shot on target as Camposano collects, perhaps looking to get Tomchuk on a streak. Hirge to Camposano. They got guys in each corner. Hirge at the top, toe poke through. No touch as Berendica was in the mix. You see Hirge looking over to the official, arguing his case that it was deflected out off Olimpia, but to no avail.
And you can see the system that Toronto's trying to employ. You see those three forwards going up there right along the goal line, trying to get that tip out there, and Hirge is definitely one of the top players in this country to lead that attack.
Reed comes down for FCT, and it'll be deflected out. And it's going to be Olimpia ball here on the near sideline, going to be inbounded by Ndubisi. Looking for space. Ndubisi chips it forward. Got Tomchuk up alone up top and just mishandles that one.
And Olimpia, you can see the number 10 in yellow out there, Gerson Berendica, saying, hey guys, let's cool it down. The Mexican native moving over to Saskatoon to make a new life for himself out there, saying, guys, let's cool this down. We got the lead. We're in the driver's seat.
Hirge makes a great move, using that speed to his advantage, but getting back in time there was Tomchuk. Hirge at the top, just going to take a crack from long range, but able to get a touch on it there was Tomchuk, but it's now a corner as it's put inside by Rodriguez. Rodriguez plays it back. Hirge, Camposano, got Smith in one corner, Reed in the middle, and Rodriguez in the far side, and deflected off the foot there, and just trying to catch Camposano off guard there was Dianchenko, but a wasted opportunity there.
And isn't that one of the most beautiful things about futsal is the goalkeepers can score? You're getting more touches in the 40-minute game, five times as many as you're getting playing outdoor soccer, which is why every single kid should be playing this sport. Ronaldo, Messi, Neymar all played futsal. You want to be like the stars? Why don't you train like them and play futsal?
Hirge trying to beat Tomchuk, and he does. Ball goes into the corner, trying to swing it in from Kovacevic, but goes straight off the chest there of Fitzroy Christie. Reed drops it to the point, back to Hirge. Hirge again at the top. Looking for an option to streak through. Just going to take a shot. Tomchuk gets in the way of that one. And looking for more movement. Reed on that far post, and now Smith taking the corner. Comes back to Camposano. Kovacevic on the far side. Hirge with the ball. Kovacevic just trying to get the chip over top and gets it inside to Reed. And Dianchenko looking for an opportunity again. But the referee right there to make the call.
Second official, Kaho Liu, doing a good job instructing the goalkeeper out there.
Trying to get clearance still here. Chris, what did you see from the call here from the second official out of the hands of Dianchenko?
Well, he's sitting there. You got to release the ball with your hands out there. And so he wanted to get that punt because he saw, obviously, the open net. And this is where kind of the inexperience comes into play out there. So now you're just having the coach here of Toronto, Nielsen, Paviv, arguing with the referee saying, hey, what's going on here?
After all that, SCT with possession in the defensive half. They come to the far side here to Reed. Plays it in the corner. Great job inside there from Kovacevic to get it into Smith. But Dianchenko up to it, makes a big save inside.
That was very, very good ball movement there from Toronto. And fortunately, Dianchenko able to stick that foot out and prevent this game from getting tied up at five.
Jurgen goes inside to Smith. Double teamed and Ndubisi with a hard challenge inside. But Smith stays upright and wins possession there for FCT. Come to the outside. Here's Campesano. Challenged in tight. Smith again, this time fouled by Christie. No, they're going to say it's a goal kick. And a clearance coming up from Dianchenko. They try to stretch the field to Domchuk. Tomchuk. And Debisi. Flicks it forward, but nobody there, as Campesano will make the easy save and rolls it out to Hyurge coming forward. And now Capone back onto the floor for FCT. But couldn't they come back in the counter and make it a two-goal lead? And just going to hold up instead. But Reed intercepts. Tomchuk was there. Now with the ball in up top and getting taken down to the floor was Andre Vitkovsky, who makes his way onto the floor for Olimpia.
Yeah, we're seeing some aggressive play. There's less than half remaining here in the second, and we're definitely going to see the intensity pick up there, Kyle.
Rodriguez to Campesano. Rodriguez taking that spot of Hyurge, who was manning the extra attacker spot at the top, kind of like that quarterback of a power play in hockey. And now we see Smith kind of down in the corner trying to make himself available, and they get it to him. Check ball coming across. It's last touched out by Vitkovsky.
Yeah, Abbott Hill-Smith out there just really reaching out and just sneaking behind his defender to open that space. And if he gets more open, it seems only inevitable that Toronto will tie it up.
Campesano gets a shot through, and the corner is not won. They say it did not touch the hand of Dianchenko. So 5-4 the lead, Chris. Under 10 minutes to go here in the second half. Again, a must-win for FCT if they want an opportunity to play in tomorrow's final. And what an absolutely huge victory it would be for Olimpia. Would make tonight's matchup a little bit obsolete in terms of the standings, but certainly to play for pride, Chris, as you mentioned earlier.
Oh, no question about it out there. And you can see the desperation coming in. David Campesano going to be switching up for what I believe to be Matias DeMarco going out as the attacker. Actually, it's going to be Eduardo Jaraguay coming in. One of the biggest and booming shots in all of Canadian futsal history. This man in the yellow kit right now.
Will they take takes the place of DeMarco, who's been that extra attacker through most of yesterday and for the early part of the second half here. Hirage gets a shot, score! And the plan works so far. Hirage ties things up 5-5.
Wow, we talked about that booming shot only seconds ago, and that's the result out there. When you give him a little bit of space, that man's going to find it most of the time. He's an absolute sniper.
So it is even now at 5, but Chris, FCT needs to continue to push here, get the 3 points, and secure at least an opportunity to play in the final and what would happen in the later game between the Sporting Outlaws and this Olimpia team. But again, they're still going to try to add to their tally here and get as much of a goal difference as they can.
Well, they're going to require it out there. You know, Olimpia is certainly no pushover, as they've proven out there and shocked the Canadian futsal community. Maybe the only ones who aren't shocked is Jaime Meza Castillo and this yellow submarine side.
Which comes to the near side here for Hyurge. And now he switches spots. Rodriguez, miscommunication there. And that's going to be another turnover on an inbound play there from Olimpia. And now you see Berendica communicating to his players. Settle things down a little bit. The game is tied. And they don't have to rush anything. Rodriguez goes outside to Reed. Now Rodriguez again at the top. Hyurge. Back to Rodriguez. Good check to the inside. And stretch from the back end. Shot through off the post. And DeBisi can't believe it. And Chris, neither can I. That looked as an absolutely perfect counter chip, and it goes off the post and stays out.
You're sitting there. You see a collective sigh of relief there from the Toronto bench out there. The last thing they want to see, obviously, is going back down. They want to put the pressure. But you know what? Big risk, big reward, or sometimes unfortunate consequence. And fortunately for them, they got away with only a few inches and still maintain the 5-5.
And DeBisi again could not believe it. Hands going on his head in the surrender cobra. The touch goes in behind. It'll be a corner kick. Upcoming for Olimpia. And taking it will be Jerson Berendika. As the whistle, or the bell sounds over at the scorer's table. See if they can clear some things up here.
Got one of my favorite referees, the third ref, Alex Chernek, out of the Ottawa Carlton Futsal League, led there by Paulo Belen. Carl Gray, one of the greatest legends in Canadian futsal history as a builder, just instructing Toronto as to what's happening right now.
Matias DeMarco getting vocal here as well. We'll see if DeMarco is going to play his way back onto the floor as he's now in the ear of Phil Benavides, who is manning the scoreboard and the official scorekeeper.
You can't bother the fourth official, especially when it's Phil Benavides, the experienced referee right here from Kingston, Ontario.
Berendika pushed to the top, and Chris, under 8 minutes to go, and here's a chance inside, but a foul there from NDBC, and I think the right call made there.
Yeah, got the contact out there, and last thing you want is that guy making that 1v1 on the keeper, and a good call there by Alexis Vaughn.
Rodriguez trying to gain into the offensive zone, and he's got Hirage to his right again, and he takes a shot through, but it's wide of the net, and him and Camposano are going to try to trade spots early and often here. But I'm surprised not to see Matias DeMarco on the floor at this point, perhaps getting some legs for the final stretch of this game. But DeMarco remains on the bench for FCT.
Without question, he'll be back in this one, and he's going to be an impact player. 7 minutes plus remaining out there. He definitely wants to make sure he has the legs to deliver his best performance, and he is undeniably going to be with Eduardo Hadagai, who's coming in right now as that fifth attacker, as we see him throw on that keeper jersey. Those two together, though, dynamic duel. That's the last thing Olimpia wants to see in this game.
Hadagai drops it back for Rodriguez, who's directing traffic. The two exchanging a couple of 1-2s. Back to the top to Samoas. Samoas on that far side. Checks inside to Reed. Back to Rodriguez. Had a bit of a lane to shoot through, but opts to come to Hirage. Now back to Rodriguez. Looking for some movement inside. Samoas is there, as is Reed and Capone. Capone vocal, trying to get the ball. Rodriguez, can he poke it loose? Goes off a leg. And back to the defensive side. But unable to get it cleanly. As a great job pushing forward by Berenik Vasily. So FCT continuing to push here with the extra attacker, trying to get the lead. It is still 5-5 in the final stretch here. About 7 minutes remaining in the second half. Again, it's a must win for FCT here. Push comes into the corner. Reed back to Hirage. Sends it through, goes off a foot there of Berendika, who remains poised, but that one was close.
And you could just see that Toronto was trying to sense this blood in the water. Hadagai, one of the more experienced players. We can't say enough about how great of a talent he is out there. And he just wants to get a little more space to make that big booted blast that he's notorious for to give Toronto the 6-5 lead.
Hirage and Rodriguez is trying to get some movement in this defensive box formation that Olimpia has at the moment. They go far side to Samoas. Now Rodriguez and Samoas with the 1-2s. Rodriguez again, they come to Hirage. Capone making some movements around on this near post. Looking for Reed back door. The movement is there, but can't quite generate anything through. Hirage goes inside to Capone, trying to get the check run back in. And that's a foul on Capone, and NDBC could be booked here. We'll see, and reaching into the pocket certainly, and NDBC getting the yellow.
Yeah, he was going, obviously, intent for the ball. No malicious intent there, but ultimately catching the ankle of Francesco Capone out there. And thankfully, it's not hurt, but definitely a big boot from the big man from Nigeria. That's the last leg you want coming in and hitting you, to say the least.
Just having a look, see if we can look down at the scorer's table, Chris, and see what the foul count looks as though at the moment. I don't think it's quite close to being danger for either side right now.
Well, we actually got four over here for Olimpia and FCT, maintaining it with zero fouls, and it's an excellent job so far in maintaining their composure.
So two fouls to give if you're Olimpia before they get into the situation of those spot kicks from the 10-meter mark. They can try to add to it before getting to that mark on their own accord. Drops it back to Rodriguez. Go far side. Rodriguez and Reed changing positions. Rodriguez still with it again. Jorge fakes the shot. Rodriguez with a chance to poke it loose. No. Trying to get that check ball inside to Reed. Can't quite turn it inside, but Samoas will do so and get it back for FCT. Good movement there by them to recollect and not have them forced back into a defensive position. Rodriguez, Jorge again. They go over to Samoas. Check ball coming from Reed. And they go across, saving it inside. Almost deflected inside to Samoas, and that's a hard foul from him. And now you see Reed and Vasily getting into it after the whistle. But Samoas with that hard foul for FCT, and it's going to be possession to Olimpia.
Yeah, well, you know what? When you have an open net out there, the last thing you want to be able to do is have that team have an open shot out there. So when you have zero fouls, it's a good one to take. And Toronto actually, in both their games so far, have been doing a great job in taking the good fouls.
And DeBisi tried to out-muscle Capone, but loses possession. And that allows Camposano to streak into the play. And we've seen Camposano already with a couple of good releases from the back end. And gets it over to Rodriguez. Slows things down. Not going to get any pressure here towards center court. Going to be a lot of space to work with if you are FCT until you reach about the three-point line of that basketball court. Off the feet there of Fitzroy Christie. He's going to try to keep everyone composed at the back end from Olimpia.
I wouldn't be surprised to see Christie on for the remainder of this game, seeing his experience and composure. And he's got to make sure that he's communicating very well to Bedendika, his defensive partner out there, and making sure that a young talent like Isaiah Reed, the number 10 in blue, isn't getting behind him and getting that tap-in slot that Toronto is desperately trying to attain right now.
So Capone will take the touch on the near sideline. Goes back to Rodriguez. Not going to waste any opportunities. They'll continue to push that and move that ball around until they get the perfect opportunity to get a shot through. But again, this box formation makes it very tough to penetrate. And we've got Reed in the corner. Now they go to Reed. Gets it through. Goes off the feet there of Dianchenko. And we are now within the final 4 minutes here, as FCT tries to push through and get the lead.
Capone just waiting along that goal line. He's just anticipating the pass coming to him, and he just really wants to make sure that he's the one to deliver this lead.
Move comes inside, and Samoas was right there, but Ndubisi with a great job clearing it off the line. Dianchenko down on the floor, looking for a whistle as he's limping. Dianchenko injured, so he may have to come off the floor.
And he's going to need to take the time and make sure that he's recovered out here, because if they lose Dianchenko, that's a very, very big loss for Olimpia, considering they don't actually have a designated second keeper coming in. So they would have to put one of their players to go in out there. So let's hope for Olympia's sake, and more importantly, for the health sake of Alexander Dianchenko, that he is indeed all right.
Dianchenko, again, there's a lot of traffic inside the goalkeeper's arc right now. Makes it very difficult to see, a lot of congestion in there, and bound to have a couple of bodies banging around, Chris. And Dianchenko on the tough end of that one, and I think hurt his leg a little bit.
And he's not 21 years old anymore out there. You know, he's no spring chicken, but, you know, 37 years of age, he's still an athletic figure out there. He's done a great job today for the Olimpia side out there. Grew up over in Kazakhstan out there, which is one of the biggest futsal nations. Most people don't think of it, but realistically, they've produced some of the best futsal teams over the last decade or so, and hopefully, for Dianchenko's sake, that it's only a short-term knock and he can get back in there.
So we're under 4 minutes. It remains a 5-5 score line at the moment. And a draw wouldn't be the absolute worst here for Futsal Club Toronto, but certainly would love the full 3 points.
Well, here's the thing is, right now, they're sitting at the bottom of the table out here. If this match goes out, they got 1 point. Olympia's got 1 point. But Olympia then controls their destiny against the Outlaws later on today. And, you know, the Outlaws obviously with a dominant 9-3 performance yesterday. That was dynamic and shocked everybody, except everyone in Quebec that have invested for years their money, their blood, sweat, and tears to become one of the most dominant, if not the most dominant province in all of Canadian futsal, as we're seeing here. But, you know, when it comes down to it, if FCT can get these 3 points and Olympia even draw or lose against Quebec later on, then, well, we'll see a repeat of yesterday's match for the final, which, again, is about tomorrow, 12 p.m., right here at Canada Soccer YouTube channel.
So, again, if it is a draw, in fact, and finishes at 5-5 or higher, then that forces Olympia into that game this evening. But if they can keep it within five goals, Chris, goal differential will come into play, and we will see Olympia in the final instead of FCT. It's back to Rodriguez, vastly there to make contact.
Let's not forget the fact that Olympia is already playing a game right now, and they got to play at 6 o'clock. Looking across the court, seeing a very relaxed, very young, very athletic, and more importantly, a very well-rested Outlaw side that got a great sleep, a good meal in, and now we got to see Olympia come in to play another game with only a few hours rest out there. So obviously, we can see the favor would be for the Quebec side in that capacity.
Yeah, you would have to think so. But again, Olympia has come out here. They got the game's first goal. FCT races back to a 4-1 lead, and then it's four straight unanswered in a row for Olympia to make it 5-4. And then Hjortage, as the extra attacker, ties things up here at five goals apiece as we are into the final home stretch here of the second half. Still 5-5, and back on the floor is Matias DeMarco. Samoish comes to the outside. Hjortage over to DeMarco, goes into the corner. Reed plays it back to the top. Movement continues. Hjortage down inside to Capone, trying to streak it through off the post. What a big time save from Dianchenko. Gets the hands down on the goal line. Wow.
Huge opportunity there for the young Isaiah Reed to bury it in, but he just couldn't get enough on it. And Dianchenko doing everything he can to preserve this point.
Push goes inside. They come up top. Hjortage gets it through. Trying to flick it loose. Goes off the chest there of Ndibisi. And a high kick from Vasily. And hard onto the floor.
It was a foul, but we definitely see Hadaguay making a meal of it out there, trying to maybe perhaps get the yellow card draw.
So it will be FCT ball. And they're going to try and play it quickly here. So they've got some dangerous options up there, Chris. They got Reed and Capone in on each post. Hjortage taking the free kick. DeMarco out to his left and Samoish on that far side. Tough for any team to defend against, but right now, that's exactly what Olympia needs to do.
You can watch that ball potentially going to Brandon Samoish, who's just begging for this pass, but
shot through, and it's a save from Dianchenko. And on the rebound, Hjortage trying to get it across with the left. And that'll be a timeout upcoming now for Olympia, and try to talk things over here, Chris.
Yeah, you know what? Number one, it's a shock they're coming in and doing 5-5 against the former national championship side out here. But boy, when you got a quality coach and more importantly, a team that plays for each other with all this heart, it's unbelievable to see just how good this is. No matter what the result is, no matter who wins or who draws out here, the reality of the situation is this has been a fantastic game out there, and Olympia now are sitting there as we see Jaime Meza Castillo saying, guys, listen, we have an opportunity not just even to contain this point 5-5. If we catch them off here, we can maybe even pull off the 6-5 with the empty net goal.
And FCT more concerned right now discussing potential non-calls, and they're getting quite vocal here. Matias DeMarco in the face of the officials right now. He's got to be careful here, Chris.
Yeah, especially since he's already on a yellow card out there. So if he gets ejected, that's a huge loss. Presuming FCT even go on to the final, that is one player I would not want to lose, because he is a player that you can base any futsal team around. He's that dynamic and that valuable of an asset to this club.
And if somehow Olympia can catch FCT on a counter right now and potentially put this into a situation where FCT would lose and play their way out of a tournament, you would have to think that the cards could be coming early and often here towards the end of this game.
Oh, no question. If it gets chippy in that regard, and you know what? Sometimes in futsal, especially in Ontario, it definitely gets chippy. And we saw that with Toronto versus Toronto United in their final out there. A very close thriller, I should say, 4-3 over in Vaughan, Ontario last month. That wasn't exactly the talk of the town, but was at the same time, if you get my meaning.
And a hard touch in there from Campesano, but bumps into his own player in the process in DeMarco at the back. And here's a shot through, trying to lay it off into the corner. Was Christie.
He was hungry for that. He really, really, really wanted to bury that sixth goal out there, but was too little ambitious with his hard pass. And now they're going to be sitting on the heels trying to defend this with only a buck 40 left in the second half.
DeMarco plays it into Hurge. Back up top to DeMarco. Goes across to Samoish. Now DeMarco again. Plays it into the corner to recheck ball inside. Saved Dianchenko. Trying to get them caught off guard again, just wide of the net. Dianchenko makes a big time save once again. And another opportunity for FCT to take the lead.
You know, as much as I love Fitzroy Christie and some of the other players here on Olimpia, you have to give the man of the match out there for Olimpia to Dianchenko, who's been spot on so far.
A minute and a half left to go here, Chris, as Christie takes the ball in the corner, battling with Reed. And that's going to be a foul now on FCT as Berendika gets pushed off the ball there by Reed.
Now Berendika drawing a good foul, and FCT have more than a few out there. That's only their second foul of the half. Highly, highly unlikely with a minute left that they'll be able to foul out, so smart move there.
Reed trying to poke it loose there from Berendika and does a great job of winning possession for his team as DeMarco calling for it now as Reed will play it in. And Hurge coming again on this near side as the extra attacker. DeMarco plays it across. Gets it right back. DeMarco loses a handle, but it's saved on the far side by Samoish. Now draws a defender out. Can they take advantage? Comes back to DeMarco. Hirge. Back to DeMarco. Looking for a lane to shoot through. DeMarco again. Goes over across to Reed. Back to DeMarco. Time running out here for FCT. DeMarco again. Comes to Samoish. Excuse me, to Hirge. DeMarco, shot through, and a chance inside for Capone, and he fans on it, chips it over top, and goes wide of the net. And Capone, Chris, looking for that for the entire second half, but can't get it to go.
You know, his dynamo.
And a foul just outside the arc. Referee not going to call it. Here's a chance back the other way, and it's wide of the net, and a shot there from Hirge.
I was surprised that foul wasn't called in favor for Olimpia out there, but now just about 16 seconds left.
Last push here for either team to try to take this game and earn a full 3 points, but the draw looks imminent at this point. DeMarco pushes it. DeMarco pushes it across to Reed. Reed trying to get that push through. Final few seconds ticking away. Christie trying to poke it loose and get the win. And that's a potential, that's a foul and a card coming to Reed. Blocking that opportunity to come through. And could that potentially have been a red, Chris?
Well, being the last man back out there in an open net, I was waiting there to see if Kaho Lu was going to give it to him, but fortunately for Isaiah Reed there, only getting the yellow, and 3 seconds left.
So that's the yellow card, and it looks as though the stretch ball going to come, and that is the game, and Olimpia ecstatic with the result, a 5-5 draw with the Ontario Champions Futsal Club Toronto, and if they can keep tonight's game within 5 goals, Chris, they will be playing in Sunday's final.
Oh, it's an unbelievable performance and speaks to the investment that Saskatchewan Soccer and the Saskatoon Futsal League and everybody trying to build this wonderful sport out there has done to get a 5-5 result in your first ever Futsal Canadian Championship game against the former national champion is a huge, huge victory for everyone in Saskatchewan. And boy, oh boy, this game at 6 o'clock is going to be so big between the Outlaws and Olimpia.
The frustration's boiling over here for FCT, Chris. Only a handful staying out for the obligatory handshakes here. So a tough, tough result here for FCT. They will likely stick around for tonight's game to see if they're going to be playing tomorrow. But it looks bleak at this point, Chris, as we see Olimpia ecstatic again with the 5-5 result. And they control their own destiny in tonight's game against the Sporting Outlaws from Quebec, and what should be another exciting game. But Chris, even so, you never want to think about it this way, but Sporting, as you mentioned, perhaps wanting to take on this Olympia team who has demonstrated that they can play with the big teams in the country, but as you said, a little bit more inexperienced, perhaps sets up a better final for them moving into tomorrow's game. So would they be a little more hesitant to run up the score in that second game tonight?
Well, you have to think, you know, they defeated Toronto very soundly yesterday, 9-3. They opened up with a 7-0 start to begin with, so they feel very comfortable playing Toronto. But Toronto also brings that experience, and they have four national team players, so there's certainly going to be no pushovers out there. Every single game is a new start out there, and Toronto would have the opportunity if they do get there. Now, however, Olympia, we saw that they do have a little bit of tactics. Certainly the most inexperienced side here in terms of futsal-specific rotations and skills, but the reality is we're even looking at them right now, and these guys are playing together. They will die for each other on this court, and the reality is I think Olympia could keep it within five without a question, as we just saw.
Game day number two, game number one is a 5-5 final between the champions from Saskatchewan, Olympia Saskatoon, and Futsal Club Toronto, the champions from Ontario. Great back-and-forth affair, but certainly the smiles being donned on the faces of those from Olympia is if they can keep tonight's game within five, they will be playing in tomorrow's final, but we have to get there first. The second game on game day two will take place tonight at 6 p.m. Eastern Time right here at the Queen's Athletics and Recreation Center on the campus of Queen's University in Kingston, Ontario. Join us on the Canada Soccer YouTube channel at 6 p.m. We will see you then for Olympia and Sporting. From Quebec, I'm Kyle Campo, joined by Chris Fernandez. We'll see you in a few hours' time.